Students, today we are going to discuss about the topic design of synchronous sequential circuits and the steps involved in design of it. Okay, so in the previous session, our previous class, we have discussed about conversion of one flip-flop into another flip-flop. It's a topic that we have discussed. In this session, we are going to discuss about design of synchronous sequential circuits. As I told you, these sequential circuits are of two types. They are synchronous sequential circuits and asynchronous sequential circuits. The main difference also I have explained in between synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuits. Clock is the main difference. Applying of clock is the main difference we can find between synchronous sequential circuit and asynchronous sequential circuits. In clock is given for all the flip-flops at a time to change its state in synchronous sequential circuits, whereas it is different. Each flip-flop will be given the clock in different times. So that is a case in terms of asynchronous sequential circuits. First, let us go and see what are the steps that are involved in design of asynchronous sequential circuits. Before you go and see and learn about design or design steps in synchronous sequential circuits, students, we should definitely learn the two state diagrams we have in general. Okay, the state diagrams in general. There are two types of state diagrams for representing any synchronous sequential circuit, students. They are Miele circuit, okay, the Miele state diagram, and second one is Moore circuit diagram. Okay, so first one is Miele circuit diagram and second one is Moore circuit diagram, okay, or state diagram. These are circuits, our state diagrams will give us the entire operation of each circuit, okay, each sequential circuit. We can represent any sequential circuit with the help of Miele or Moore state diagram, okay, Miele or Moore state diagram, by giving which input you are going to which state, which output state from which present state. That every information we can represent with the help of these state diagrams, students, with the help of these state diagrams. Remember, these state diagrams are of two types. We can represent with the help of Miele state diagram or with the help of Moore state diagram. We can represent a sequential circuit. Okay, so let us let me explain how this Miele state diagram will represent moving from one state to another state. Students, look at here. This is Miele circuit diagram, okay, or Miele state diagram here. You can see these states 00, 01, 10, 11 are my present state, which are there now in the circuits or present states or available states in the state diagram or for the sequential circuits. Listen here, students. Using this Miele circuit diagram or state diagram or Moore state diagram or circuit diagram, we can represent the working of a sequential circuit, okay, synchronous sequential circuit here. Let us see how we can represent using Miele state diagram here. We have four states here, that is 00, 01, 10, 11 in here. These are the states available in the synchronous sequential circuit we have. This is an example state diagrams, students. There are four states, 00, 01, 10, and 11 are the four states. You can see I have an arrow mark here. It is moving from 00, again reaching 00. And they have written 0/0 in here or 0/0 in here, which means that what is written on the top? You have 0/0. What is there on the top? Numerator will represent the input, and what is there in the denominator will represent its output, students. Okay. This entire representation denotes that presently I am in 0/0 state. By giving an input 0, I am reaching the same state 0/0 again, and I am producing an output 0. That is the meaning of this notation, students. You can see these arrow marks are very, very important here. Okay, 0/0 is my present state now. By applying an input 0, I am reaching the same state 0/0 with an output 0, producing an output 0. And similarly, look at here, students. I have the state 0/0. By giving an input 1, I am reaching the state 10 with an output 0, So for each and every state, we can give an input 0 or we can give an input 1. For example, for this 0, 0 state, by producing an input or by giving applying an input 0, I am reaching the same state with an output 0. Whereas for the same state 0, 0, when I produce or apply, when I apply input 1, I am reaching the state 1, 0 with an output 0. Like that, the working or the working procedure of a given synchronous sequential circuit can be represented with the help of state diagram, students. Okay, so like that, you can see here, when I'm reaching the state 0, 1, if I give an input 0, again it is reaching the same state 0, 1 and producing an output 0. And in the case if 0, 1 is given with an input 1, it is reaching the state 0, 0 with an output 0 here. Like that, for each state 1, 0, when I'm giving 0 input to the 1, 0, you can see in this direction, it is reaching 1, 1, then producing an output 0. Whereas for the state 1, 0, if I give an input 1, it will come back again to the same state, producing an output 1. Let us go for the last state here. I have the last state 1, 1 in here. By giving an input 0 here, okay, by giving an input 0 here, it is reaching the state 0, 1 and producing an output 0 here, okay. And in the case, if 1, 1 is given with an input 1, it is reaching the same state 1, 1 and producing an output 0 here. This is how we need to design or analyze the Miele circuit. Students, do you got what are the components available in the Miele circuit and how we got to analyze the given state diagram? Students, do you understand how to analyze the Miele circuit diagram? Students, are you there? Students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, do you got an idea how to analyze this circuit diagram?
Sir, one second, tell me, sir.
Yeah, look at here. Students, I have 4 states in this state diagram. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Think this Miele circuit, this diagram representing some sequential circuit, okay, synchronous sequential circuit, having the state 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. And we can move from one state to another state by giving some input. At that time, it may produce some output, students. That is what is happening inside the circuit, okay? Since I have 4 states, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, if I give an input to the given state or any state out of these 4, we can move to other state or we can stay in the same state by producing some output in here. That is what I'm explaining in this entire circuit, students. Look at here. If I take a state, for example, 1, 0, okay, if I'm thinking to analyze about the state 1, 0. Look at here, I am lying in the state 1, 0. What is there inside the circuit is representing about the state. So 1, 0 is a state. And you can see something here, 1 by 1. You can see something like 1 by 1, which is there in the numerator on the top is denoting about input. What is there in the bottom denominator value? It denotes your output value. Now look at here. If I am thinking to analyze about the state 1, 0, I am presently in the state 1, 0. By giving an input 1 to the state 1, 0, I can come back again to the same state. Okay, see, to the arrow mark, I am representing this one. Currently, I am at the state 1, 0. By giving an input to the 1, 0 state, I will again reach the same state. I'm not going anywhere. I'm reaching again to the same state 1, 0 and producing an output 1 in here. That is the meaning of the state. Students, do you understand now how to analyze about this thing? Arrow mark, you need to see the arrow mark. Currently, I'm in the state 1, 0. By giving an input 1, I'm coming back to the same state, producing an output 1 in here. Like this, if I'm presenting at the state 1, 0, okay, I'm moving in this direction from 1, 0. By giving an input 0 to 1, 0, I'm reaching the state 1, 1 and producing an output 0. Guys, do you understand now how to analyze this circuit diagram for each state in Miele circuit state diagram? Any doubts till now in Miele circuit analysis?
Understand, sir.
Yeah, now let us go to the Moore circuit. Students, there is a small difference you can find. There is a small difference you can find between Miele state diagram and Moore state diagram. Look at here, guys, in the circle, okay, in the circle, in the Miele circuit, you can see only the state, and present input is shown on the numerator value behind the arrow, and output value is shown after the, in the denominator, we can say, okay, input and output shown here, and only the state is shown inside the circle. Whereas if you go for the Moore circuit, see in the Moore circuit, I have four states, A, B, C and D. There are four states. Look at here, students, very important aspect you have to observe here is inside the circle, not only your state, they have represented the output of the state also. They have represented the output of the state also. If you're reaching the state, the output remains zero, whether you're giving an input zero or one to reach the state, its output remains constant always. If you're there in the state A, if you're reaching the state A, always its output is zero. Okay, if you're reaching the state B, its all output always zero. If you're reaching the state C, its output is always one. If you're reaching the state D, its output is always zero here, okay? But that is the difference. In Miele state diagram, they are giving only the state inside the circle. Input and output is shown in here. Okay, input and output is shown here. If 0, 0 is given with the input 0, you're reaching the same state with an output 0. Whereas if 0, 0 is given with input 1, it is reaching the state 1, 0 with an output 0. Means we are representing input and output both at a time in here. Okay, but when you move to the Moore circuit, Moore state diagram, look at here, friends. Your output is also shown inside the circle itself. Okay, for the state A, your output is always zero. For the state B, output is always zero. For the state C, output is always one. For the state D, output is always zero. Output is also shown inside the circle itself along with the state. Look at here how to analyze this one. Students, let us assume that we are in the state A. See what is there around the arrow. When you are there in the state A, when you give the input zero to the state A, you're reaching again to the same state. Whereas if you are there in the state A and if you produce or apply input one to it, you will be reaching the state C. And when you're reaching the state C, students, your output is one always. Okay, one always. Now let us go to the state B now. You are now there in the state B, students. And by producing an input zero to it, by applying input zero to it, we are reaching the same state B. And while your output is zero. And what about now tell me, students, if you are there in the state B, if you are producing or if you are applying an input one to it, which state you are reaching from the circuit? If you are there in the state B, if you are applying an input one to it, you will be reaching the state A. After reaching the state A, its output is zero always. Okay. Zero. That is how you need to analyze the Moore circuit. Okay. The only difference you can find between Miele circuit and Moore circuit is in Miele circuit, inside the circle, there will be only state. Input and output will be shown around the arrow mark to which state you are moving by applying which input and you are getting what output. But whereas in the Moore circuit, only input will be shown at the arrow marks to which side, which state you are going to move. But the state and output both will be shown inside the circle itself. Okay, inside the circle itself means for each state in the Moore circuit, for each state, there will be a single output always. Even though if you're giving input zero or one to reach that state, always its output is zero. For the state, they have decided clearly what output you have to get, what output you're going to get. If you're reaching the state A, automatically output remains zero always. That is how. But whereas if you go for the Miele circuit, based on the input and present state, always your next state and output will be changing always. Guys, do you understand what is the difference you can find between Miele circuit and Moore circuit? Way of analyzing also, do you understand? Or do you have any doubts in these two circuits?
No, sir.
Yeah. Now, guys, we have seen how to represent a synchronous sequential circuit with the help of Miele circuit and Moore circuit, or state diagram, we can call them. Okay. State diagram will give you what are the states available in it, what are the inputs you're going to apply for each state, what state you're going to reach by applying zero input and one output, one input, and what output you will receive when you're reaching some state A or B or C or D. So entire information you can get from a state diagram when you're representing about asynchronous sequential circuit. Now, guys, we need to understand how to design a synchronous sequential circuit if they have given us a state diagram. Okay. If they are going to give a state diagram and they're asking us to design a synchronous sequential circuit, we have few steps that we have to follow for designing it. Okay. Let us see, students. I'm going to show you how we need to design asynchronous, how we have to design, how we can design a synchronous sequential circuit with the help of state diagram if they have given, and with the help of flip-flops what we have. Students, what are the flip-flops we have designed so we have discussed so far? We know about what are the flip-flops we know about so far?
SR
flip-flop, D flip-flop, T flip-flop, and JK flip-flop. These are the four. Yeah, we know all about all these four flip-flops. They may ask anything, students. They may ask to design the given synchronous sequential circuit with the help of state diagram by using D flip-flop or T flip-flop or JK flip-flop or SR flip-flop. They may ask anything, their choice. But we should know what is the procedure to apply and procedure we need to apply for designing a synchronous sequential circuit. Okay, this is also one of the important topic for exam in the examination point of view. Students, let us listen how to design a synchronous sequential circuit with the help of a state diagram what they have given. Now let us take an example and see how to design it. Listen, look at the slide, students. I'm showing you how they will ask to design a sequential circuit. Has one input and one output. The state diagram is shown in the below figure. Design a sequential circuit with D flip-flop, T flip-flop, SR flip-flop, and JK flip-flop. Since this is an example, we are going to design the given synchronous given sequential circuit with the help of all the flip-flops. Okay, but in the exam they won't ask all the flip-flops to design the given sequential circuit, to design a sequential circuit with the help of all the flip-flops. But they may ask you to design only with the help of a single flip-flop, students, single flip-flop. Okay, so here they have shown how to design with the help of D, T, SR, and JK with the help of a state diagram what they have shown. Let us see, students, what we have to do to design a sequential circuit with the help of this sequential circuit. Now, students, now you have to say this to me. Look at the slide and look at the state diagram what they have shown and tell me how many states are available in the given sequential circuits, sequential circuit with the help of state diagram. Tell me how many. Yeah, what are the states?
0 0 1 1 0 0.
Yeah, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 are the four states we have in the given state diagram. You can see clearly. Now look at here, students. If you are there in the state 0 0, if I give an input 0, where you are going to reach? Tell me. If I am there in the state 0 0, and if I give input 0, to which state you are reaching? What output you are generating?
0, sir.
Yeah, if you are there in the state 0 0, if you give an input 0, you are reaching the same state, okay, and producing an output 0 here. Whereas if you are there in the state 0 0, if you give an input 1 to it, which state you are reaching then, and what is your output at the time? If you are there in the state 0
reaching
0,
1 0, sir.
Yeah, what is the output at the time?
1, sir.
1 always. Okay, like this we need to analyze the entire circuit, and we need to table all the information what you have into a single table that is called state table. Okay, from the state diagram we need to design a state table. Now that state table will give us the entire information what is available in the state diagram. That is your step one we have to do in the design procedure or design process. From the state diagram, analyze the state diagram and formulate a table which gives the entire information about this sequential circuit. Okay, sequential circuit. And look at here, this is your state table, students. Since I have 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 states with 2 bits in it, I'm taking A and B to represent that. Okay, to represent first bit, I'm taking A. To represent the second bit, I'm taking B, students. Okay, so that is how you need to design a state table. Look at here, I have 4 states, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, 4 states in it. So as a present state, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, I'm taking here. Since I have 2 variables here, 2 bits here, I'm taking A and B to represent the each bit. Now we need to analyze this. Since we have seen clearly, if you are there in the state 00, by giving an input 0 to it, you are reaching the same state 00 with an output 0. That we are going to represent in this one. See here, students. First, I am taking state 00, okay, 00. By giving an input 0 to it, x is your input, student. By giving an input x is equal to 0 to it, I am reaching the same state 00. When x is equal to 0 is given, your output is 0 here. Students, can you see what I'm doing, what I'm writing here in the state table? These are the next states. Okay, next states. When input x is equal to 0 is given, when input x is equal to 1 is given for the states what we have. And the same, we are representing the outputs. For the state 00, when I'm giving x is equal to 0 as input, what is the output? When x is equal to 1 is given, what output you're getting, I'm going to represent in this table. Students, I'm going to check this table. We are going to formulate or design this table from this state diagram. Let us see one thing randomly, whether we are formulated the table, state table exactly or not. Let us take a state 10 in here. Student, you have to say this to me. Okay, let us take the last state 11. Tell me, students, if I am there in the state 11, that is my present state 11, if you give an input 0 to it, which state you are moving from 11? If I give input 0, which state you are moving? If I'm there in the state 11, if my input is 0, which state you are moving, students?
00,
at that time, what is my output?
1.
Let us look at that. Have you written exactly correct or not? Okay, into the state table. Look at here, students. 11 is my present state. By giving an input x is equal to 0 to it, we are reaching to the state 00. Okay, we are there in the state 11, present state. By giving an input 0, we are moving to the state 00. At that time, my output is 1. Output, check here about the output. I'm lying in the state 11. By giving an input x is equal to 0, I'm moving to the state 00. And when x is equal to 0, output is 1. And likewise, we will go for the another input. If I'm there in the state 11, if I give an input 1 to it, which state I'm moving, what is my output, students?
10.
Yeah, 10 is the next state and output is 0 here. And let us see in the state table. When I'm there in the state 11, when input is 1 given, I'm moving to the state 10. At the time, my output is 0. Like this, for each state, when input is 0, what is my next state and what is my output? Like that, I have formulated a table. This table is called state table. Students, do you have any doubt in representing or designing state table from the state diagram? Any doubts in this one? If you have any doubts, I will explain this state table once again. Okay, then if there are no doubts, let me move to the next state, students. Let us go for the design part. Since we all very well know about how to design, just we need to take the help of K-maps. Okay, we need to take the help of K-maps. Then for the equation, what you have got, simplified equations, what you have got from K-map, we need to design with the help of flip-flop, students. Since in the question, they have asked us to design with the help of D flip-flop, T flip-flop, SR and JK with all flip-flops, we got to know how to design with the help of each flip-flop. Students, for a while, just keep the D flip-flop aside. Let us discuss about how to design with the help of SR flip-flop first of all, since that will give you clear-cut idea how to design with the help of SR flip-flop. See here, we'll go for design with the help of SR flip-flop here, okay? So that is what we are going to see first of all. Look at here, students. We have seen how the state diagram is looking, and we have analyzed it, and we have designed a state table from it. Then we are going for design with the help of SR flip-flop. For designing with the help of SR flip-flop, first of all, you should write the excitation table of SR flip-flop. We should know the excitation table of SR flip-flop. The last before session, we have designed how to write an excitation table for each flip-flop we have seen, students. With the help of present state and next state, what we have designed or we have written the possible input combinations clearly. Guys, do you remember the excitation tables of each and every flip-flop? Students, do you remember the excitation table for each and every flip-flop?
Yes, sir.
Then write it. Since we are trying to design with the help of SR flip-flop, okay, then write the excitation table of SR flip-flop here. Students, don't get confused. Sometimes they are written writing like RS flip-flop. Don't get confused. Both are same. SR flip-flop or RS flip-flop, both are same here only. Just way of representation is different. They're taking R input here, S input in here. If you're writing SR flip-flop, you take the values of S first, values of R next. Both are same only. You take S inputs here, R excitations in here, okay? Then after writing the excitation table of a SR flip-flop, now you need to move for a table called a transition table. Okay, transition table you need to design here, students. Let me tell you, what are the things that will be available in design table or transition table. This can be called also be called as a design table. Students, what are the present state we have available in the state table? What are the present states available in the state table or state diagram? What are the states
zero,
available?
Zero.
Yeah. Zero, zero,
zero, zero,
zero, 01.
01,
yeah.
10, 11.
Yeah. Yeah, these are the four states available, students. Along with that, look at there. We are representing the same. AB we have taken under that 00 when input is 0. 00 when input is 1. 01 when input is 0. 01 when input is 1. Same. 10 when input is 0 and 1. When 11 state when input is 0, when input is 1. We have to take present states. And for the corresponding inputs, you have to write. Then tell me, students, go to the transition table. Now we will go to the transition table and see if you are there in the state 00 and if input is 0, okay, when input is 0, what state you are moving to? That is called next state. Okay, we have represented next state here. When input is 00 and my input is 0, what state you are moving to? That you have to represent here, students. Let us go to the transition table here, students. Okay, this is your state table. When input is 0, when present state is 00 and when my input is 0, what state you are moving here? What state you have moved to, students?
00, sir.
And what is my output at the time?
0, sir.
Yeah. Now, let us go to the design table now, since we are designing with the help of SR. So my present state is 0. When I'm giving input 0, I'm moving to the state 00. At the time, my output is 0. Okay, students, flip-flop outputs. For a while, just you forget about flip-flop outputs. We'll think about that later. We'll try to fill the table, this design table, first of all, with the help of state table, what we are having. Okay, just we are going to take or retrieve what is the information available in the state table. Your present state is 0. When input is 0 given, when input is 0, you are moving to the state 00. At that time, my output is 0. When your state is 00, when input is 1, you are moving to the state 10. At that time, my output is 1. These present state, input, and next state and output all available in the state table itself or state diagram itself. The only thing you have to write from your knowledge is these flip-flop inputs. Those flip-flop inputs you'll be writing with the help of excitation table alone. Very simple, students. From the excitation table, you have to fill this flip-flop input, students. Look at here, students, how to design. Students, present state, input, next state, and output. Can we easily fill the information from the state table or not? Entire information is available in the state table. Can we fill that from your state table or not?
Yes, sir.
Now look at here, how to fill this flip-flop inputs. Since we are designing with the help of RS flip-flop, we need to take the inputs of RS flip-flop alone. Here, we need two flip-flops here. We need two flip-flops here, students. Okay, since you have four states, we need two flip-flops. If you have eight states, okay, or six states, we need three flip-flops, students. Okay, guys, students, do you understand what I'm saying? Since four states are available, we need two flip-flops for design. If you have eight states, we need three flip-flops, students. Keep this in the mind. No one will ask anything More than that, to design with the four flip-flops, something like that won't come. With the help of two flip-flops or three flip-flops is a majority case. If you have four states in your state diagram, you need two flip-flops for designing it. If you have eight states, then you need three flip-flops in here. How many states they have given in the state diagram, students? Four states: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So we need two flip-flops, SR flip-flops or RS flip-flops for designing. Let us assume that there are two flip-flops, that is flip-flop A, flip-flop B now. Look at here. Now I'm going for RS flip-flop A, RS flip-flop B here. Now we need to fill the content inside the flip-flop inputs with the help of excitation tables. Tell me, students, what we are doing with the excitation table, how you are going to fill this excitation table RS values, how you have filled these values. Tell me, students, how you have filled this RS values with the help of what values, how you have designed this excitation
present table? State, net state, sir.
Yeah, that is exactly correct answer. We have filled this excitation table values with the help of present state and next state values. Here also, your flip-flop inputs for RASA, RBSB, flip-flop A inputs, flip-flop B inputs will be designed or entered with the help of present state and next state values only. Look at here, students. You can see the present state values here. You can see the next state values here. How you have to fill here? You have present state A values, next state A values. From that, you need to fill RASA values. From the present state B value and next state B value, you need to fill RBSB values. Let us see how we have to fill. Tell me, students, what is your first value in present state A? What is the first value? And what is the first value in next state A?
Zero.
Now, in the present state, I'm having zero. And present state, I have next state, I'm having zero. If present state zero, next state zero, what will be your excitation values for R and S? See the excitation table. If present state, next state are zero, what are your RS values? Tell me, students, what is your R and S values? What are your RS values if present state zero, next state zero? What you can see? You can see in the screen. What are the values of R and S in the excitation table? Don't care? Zero. Don't care, zero. So present state A, next state A values are analyzed and it is 0, 0. For 0, 0, your RS values are don't care, zero. So in RASA, you write don't care, zero here. So I'm writing don't care, zero. Now let us move for RBSB first values. Present state B value zero, next state B value zero. If we have 0, 0, then what is your RS value, students?
Don't care zero.
Yeah, so under RBSB, you also write don't care zero. That is how you need to fill flip-flop inputs. Let us move for the next thing, guys. Here in A, present state value zero and next state value under A is one. For 0, 1, what are your RS values?
0, 1.
0, 1. So in RASA, you write 0, 1. Like that, for B, you look here. Under B, I'm having 0. Under B here, 0. For 0, 0, what is your excitation?
Don't care 0.
Yeah, don't care 0. So I have written don't care 0 under RBSB. Like that, you check your present state A value, next state A value. Look at your excitation table, fill RASA value. Look at your B value, next state B value, check your next state B value. Look at your excitation table value, fill your RBSB values into this. Students, present state, next state, input and output we have seen and written from transition table, or sorry, state table. Only the thing, flip-flop inputs we have written from excitation table value. Okay, excitation table, students. These excitation, and one more thing is, the number of flip-flops, how many flip-flops we have to select, we have to choose for the design, can be selected like this. If there are four states, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, you choose two flip-flops for the design, SARA, SBRB, two SR flip-flops. If there are eight states, select three flip-flops, SARA, SBRB, SCRC, like that. Use three flip-flops and try to fill your flip-flop inputs. Okay. Now, this entire design table is completed, students. Is there any doubts in the design table? Filling the elements into the design table. Any doubts? Tell me, guys. I will explain the design table once again.
No, sir.
Oh, okay. Present state. Based on the present state and input, we have filled the next state and output. Based on the present state and next state values from the excitation table, we have filled the flip-flop input, students. That is how we have designed this design table. Now we will go for the simplification step, students. Okay. That is how. Look at here. How many outputs are there? Flip-flop out, inputs are there? How many flip-flop inputs are there, students, totally? How many flip-flop inputs are there in the table, design table? RA, SA, RB, SB. There are four values, four inputs. RA, SA, RB, SB, four input values are there. How many outputs are there, students? How many outputs are there? Single output, Y. Yeah, single output, Y here. So four flip-flop inputs, single output. There are five elements we got to check here for the design procedure. Let us go to the next slide. So we are going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five K-maps here for getting their expressions. Okay, we have to design five K-maps here and we need to get its expressions. Look at here. How many inputs are there? A, B, okay, A, B, and your input X. There are three inputs here, students, A, B, X. Using this A, B, X, using the values of RA, SA, RB, SB, and Y, we need to design K-maps here, okay? So A, B, X are the input variables. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 K-maps to design. For RA, SA, RB, SB, and for output Y, we need to take 5 K-maps. Okay, tell me, students, how you are going to fill the K-map in values which are there inside the K-map. How you are going to get for RA? How you are going to get the values which are there inside the K-map for RA? From where you are getting those values?
RA flip-flop.
Yeah, here in the design table, you can see the values under RA. These values you have to take into the K-map directly. And A, B, X are your input variables. Students, tell me which variable K-map these all were? Which variable K-map? Two variable, three variable, four variable?
Three variables.
Three variable. A, B, X are the inputs. Take the values for RA from RA, for SA from the table, design table. For RB from the design table, for SB from the design table, for the output Y from the design table, and group them.